I'm Andreas Hau, co-founder and managing partner of Eventures, together with Christian Leibold, my partner, and Linda. We are running the European activities. So venture capitalists like to spend their time with innovative companies and, you know, disruptive business models. Yeah, but if you look at venture capital itself, it's quite a conservative, not really disrupting industry. They are, you know, like to invest in the same companies, the same segment. There's this golden rule in the Valley: you don't invest in a company you can't reach with car drive. And it's usually a partnership where you have some cowboys investing on their own and finding their way around. And we thought that's the wrong approach. And in digital business, if you're successful, you have to go very fast. And so when we first founded the fund in 1998, we founded a company in Silicon Valley and as well in Germany, bridging the new world and also doing some kind of business model arbitrage, trying to find opportunities and to help companies to go in one another. So we are more or less global. Today we have 5 funds. We invest with an own team on the ground in Brazil and in Russia, Asia, and in Europe and in the US as well, as I mentioned. But I don't want to do this usual advertising pitch. So I think if you're looking for a partner you will found a company with and grow a company with, and it's a little bit like a marriage, you really should do your own due diligence. And the best way of doing a due diligence is talking to portfolio companies, to entrepreneurs of the portfolio companies. They are listed on the websites, and just get an intro or talk to them. What they say about the venture capitalists. And so I did this, or we do this frequently. I asked them, some of them, why did they choose us and how do they feel about it? And I mean, you're invited to do the same and to check whether I'm telling the truth or am I lying. But you should really try to talk to them. And which was, some of them said, you know, we really like you because you brought our business international. It's easy for us because, you know, we are in 5 different regions with own teams on the ground. We know a lot of people there. So it's easy for us to start, for example, a US fashion company is now launching their business activity via a joint venture in Asia. We have companies launching same-day delivery service developed in Europe and different other regions. So we really help them to get their feet on the ground and to do the They also like As I said, what they said, thank you. Because you, I founded the company. Talking about a guy in Russian who was, it's better, yeah? Talking about, that doesn't really work.
Does it work? Very good. I'm talking about a guy in Russian who developed a great piece of software. And he said, you know, founding an own company, you know, renting an office space, organizing Christmas party, hiring and firing people, that's not my piece of business. I just want to develop software. And we said, you know, your software is quite popular already, and you should think about founding a company, and we help you there. We found a company together in the US, and now he's the owner, shareholder, managing director, founder, chief technology officer, quite a big company. Having more or less 20%, close to 20% of the world market for web service. I'm talking about Nginx. And that's someone who was, you know, just one guy having a great idea, having great technology understanding, and he's now running a global business activity. So he said, you know, hiring the people, finding the structure, that's something we really like about you. But we are also giving advice to people to sell too early. You know, if you talk about the banker Rothschild, and he was asked one day how he got so rich, and he said, I was always selling too early. That's a good advice to some startup companies. That's not really in the interest of a lot of VCs, because they really are aiming for the big goal, and they rather write off companies instead of making a good living out of a good company. And so we had one case in Germany, a very disruptive business model, a very smart team. And they were so disruptive with their business model that a lot of huge players in the market started to do their own business and try to, you know, compete against them. And we advised them to talk about a merger. And they were bought by a very huge German media company, and now they're running an international business with the help of this marketing of this media company, and they're very happy. So it wasn't a success case of NASDAQ and whatever for the VC and 150 times X, but it was very good for the entrepreneur. And I think having a common business, you have to really love doing what you're doing, and we love to be entrepreneurs. I myself have been an entrepreneur. I've started 15 companies. I was a business angel, and I think I understand quite a bit about starting a company, and my colleagues on the technical side, but also on the entrepreneurial side, do so. So we really love to work with entrepreneurs, and if you share this passion, we are very happy to talk to you and giving you advice. Thanks a lot.